Don't touch a dime. Keep it right where it's at. There's something big coming up on your screen. Just settle back and relax, cause you're gonna get a whole lot of singing, a whole lot of laughing, a whole lot of loving from me.
What a beautiful audience. I feel pretty good tonight, but, you know, I think I'm starting to walk in my sleep again. Yeah, this morning I woke up and there were footprints on the ceiling. We had such a wonderful party at our house last night. It was in honor of Les Brown, because he's got such a great band and such great arrangements. Yeah, Les showed up with his wife and his girlfriend, which is one of the greatest arrangements I ever heard of. A lot of fun last night. When I got up this morning, I looked myself right in the eye, and if you think that's easy, you try it without a mirror. No. I had a nice, real nice day. My kids came home from school early, you know, and they surprised me. They came in and told me they washed my car. Yeah, now all they gotta do is get it out of the pool and dry it. I love to get you on a slow boat to China, all to myself alone. Get you, give you in my arms evermore. Leave all your lovers weeping on the faraway shore. Out on the briny, big and shiny, melting your heart of stone. I love to get you on a slow boat to China. Well, all to myself alone. Out on the briny, big and shiny, melting your heart of stone. I'm out to get you on a slow boat to China. What am I yelling about? I got the job. To myself. On a boat. Oh, what a singer this. Oh, he sings like a bird. And his tonsils must sleep in a bird cage. Well, let me tell you about my wonderful guest tonight. My pal Bing Crosby's here. And Bing's such a nice guy, I'm telling you. He's always bringing me presents. Like today, he brought me a gift that really warmed my heart. A mustard plaster. Yeah, and I never saw such a relaxed guy. Every night after dinner, he puts a leash on his turtle and takes it out for a walk. And one of the greatest lady singers of all time, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lena Horne, she is here. And then we had the funny Dom DeLuise. He came over to the house last night, and he wouldn't even have a drink. Yeah, all night long, I'm making him martinis, and he's pouring them into the goldfish bowl. I never would have found out if I didn't see that goldfish jump out of the bowl and mug the cat.
Hold it, Dean.
But I want to hold it.
Hold it. Hold it, Dean. Hold it. I heard. Thank you. Save it for the end. I heard what you said about me, Dean.
What did
me,
I say?
Me who nursed you when you were hungry, fed you when you were, all... hungry also. I feed him whenever he's hungry or
what
anything.
What do you think I buy these cards for? Look at him.
I fed you when you were sick. and all that stuff, and I picked you up when you were down and out.
What in heaven's name are you talking about?
Last night after the party. Don't you remember? Oh. And that's where the laugh is.
What?
Listen, but just to prove to you that I don't hold a grudge. Grudge. Go on. You're free. I got a song for you, a perfect song. Listen, Dino.
How does it go?
Here it is. All right, hit it more or less. Vicky, I'm tricky and slightly ricky-ticky, but life could be kicky with you. One, two, three, you made it sicky. You made it also wicky-wacky, Vicky. Oh, Vicky, it's you.
Get out of here. That's Don Eloise, my pal. He's a real funny guy, and you'll see lots more of him later on. And you're going to save it for the end.
Lena Horne. The question is, how do you feel about Lena Horne? Well, somebody would ask me, how do you feel about working with a living legend? That's what Lena Horne was. I mean, I was in awe of Lena Horne. Lena Horne could just do a song and just arch an eyebrow, and you just, you know, the emotion, the feelings that she had with the song. And Dean enjoyed working with her because she was a major, you know, professional, marvelous, wonderful star.
Whenever skies look gray to me and trouble begins to brew, whenever the winter winds become too strong, I concentrate on you. When fortune cries and people declare you're through, whenever the blues become my only song, I concentrate on you, on your smile, so sweet, so tender. When at first my kiss you decline,
This is quite an occasion.
Champagne,
yeah. Oh, yes. I've had this on ice for 2 years. You know, just waiting for you to come on this show.
Well, this is too much. Roses in the dressing room and champagne. I can't stand it.
Well, you know, just let me, you know, spoil you a little, that's all.
Okay.
Okay? Yeah. But it's, you know... Oh, boy. Did you say anything?
Can we sing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, it's not a very classy tune. It's just, yeah, it's just bumming around.
Well, I'd enjoy bumming around with you a little bit.
Got an old slouch hat. I got my roll on my shoulder. Well, I'm as free as a breeze, and I'll do as I please.
Just bumming around. I got a million friends. I won't feel any older.
I got nothing to lose, not even.
never worry, starts to bothering me.
I'll grab my coat, my old slouch hat, hit the trail again, you see.
I ain't got a dime.
I don't care where I'm going.
I'm as free as a breeze, and I'll do as I please. Just bumming around. Whenever worries start to bother me,
well, I grab my coat, my old slouch hat, hit the trail again, you see.
I ain't got no dime.
Don't care where I'm going.
I'm as free as the breeze, and I'll do as I please. Just bumming around. Just
bumming
around. Just.
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 Around.
Miss Lena Horne, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure those of us who have been exposed to the talents of Jonathan Winters will agree that he is an unchallenged master of improvisation. We thought an old attic might be fun, so we'll turn him loose, and I guarantee you he'll turn you on.
Hi there. So you're Roy Sefton, huh? Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I never thought I'd be shot in the bathtub, that's all. Fooled you, didn't I? Huh? Here I am, stark naked, but I got my guns on me.
Well, a lot of people ask me why I have this. Because, right? Or if the balloon comes down, same thing, right? Well, you don't bend them up. Or forward, like that. That's the reason for it. I'm Carl Schaeffer, by the way. I used to carve little birds. Then I got in the war.
How you doing, Miss Matthews? I want to thank you for packing my lunch for me. Still got a peanut butter and jelly in there, Miss Matthews. How long you been dead?
Tired of your old boarding house.
Miss Stone. Are you Ruth Stone? Yes, I'm the dressmaker. Like my little stool? Sit on it all day long. This is my sewing machine. Here, my dear. Oh, no, don't be frightened. I would never harm you. Let me try the dress on you here. Put this on. That's right. My, you're a beautiful girl. Yes. I have... Oh, yes, here I have all the pins. Yeah. I'll put these here. That's all for today. I can't fit the dress. I just swallowed 37 pins.
I want to thank all the people here at Winterford Bowling Alleys for giving me this here trophy. Boy, it's probably the greatest thrill we ever had down at the company.
And I was captain of the team, as you know, and for to get this is just about the biggest thrill I've ever had in my life. I could never get over this laugh, and I knew you folks would get me out of the war. Come on, grandson. Oh, there you are. You moved from over there right here like a little bandit, didn't you? I believe that's the old 614 coming down the track now. Now, son, it's all wore off. Yeah, I better signal, grandson. You paying attention? Don't play around the track now. Stand back here. Oh, wasn't that some train now? Run right over my feet. I guess I can wear your shoes now.
A lot of people ask, what do I do up here in the attic? I always come up here at noontime, work on this ship. It took me over 5 or 6 months to just paint the sheets. Here down here is the boat itself. Huh? Pathetic, ain't it?
You know, here at SeaWorld, we have an awful lot of fun. I'm Fred Dinglehoofer. I go right in there into the tank with the giant mammals and octopuses and everything. Oh, yeah. Swim around the shark and everything. It's an awful lot of fun. I've been bit thousands of times. I don't care. This is the last time I'm driving your little funky car. Play it on about your business. You tell me something.
I'm part Paul Tebler. At the beginning of, at the halftime, I'm the drum major. Oh, time for the game to begin. Oh, dear. Mr. Fettolini. I'm Chester Honeyhugger, and I want to get my hair cut. My parents are waiting in the car. Is this a barber chair? It is, isn't it? I can tell. Mommy said to just cut a little on the sides, and in the back there, and not too in front here, too. Okay, Mr. Fettolini? You're a nice man. Oh, your breath is strong. You know, when you're in a little boy like this in a little chair, you can't get away from a person. What do you eat? Okay, you're going to cut my hair now? Is it all over? Have you cut already? My curls are all gone. Bad man. Give me your scissors a minute. Thank you. I just was kidding.
These are some of the flowers I've grown. They're not much, but they took second. Aren't they lovely? Oh, my gosh, a bee went up into my face. Oh, sting me, sting me.
Goldie Hans is here. I tell you, she's cute. Blue eyes, beautiful skin, and you ought to see her hair, babe. You gotta see her. You gotta see her hair. Now, you bring her... Now, bring the cards a little closer. I had a little trouble seeing lately. My doctor said I should try standing a little closer to my eyes. You know, I don't think Goldie's too bright. I saw her in the parking lot this afternoon, and she was sitting in her car crying. She said someone stole her steering wheel, the brakes, the accelerator, and the whole dashboard. And I said, Goldie, don't cry no more. You're sitting in the back seat. Yeah, but I'd like to introduce Goldie Hawn right now, but she went to Hollywood. No. This ain't the same show, is it? Oh, well, listen. I'd like to introduce Goldie Hawn right now, but she went to a Hollywood premiere with Dom DeLuise. Now, let's see what's going on over there.
I saw him. He was stopped at a red light, and I went up to his windshield. I wrote, I love you, with a wet Tootsie Roll on it.
Oh, that's it. Oh, it's all over. Well, come on. Want to go home?
No.
Huh?
No, I just want to stay around here a while.
But there's nobody here. Well, you're just going to stick around alone and just...
Yeah, well... I just want to do that.
Okay, well, I'm going home. You got movie stars on the brain. That's what you want.
She goes to every premiere. Gosh, I'm standing in Joan Crawford's feet. When she spends her time and her very last dime hoping her favorite stars will appear. Lana Turner. When every leading man makes her feel small feet. The chances are the ladies are stars. If the lady's naughty but proper, if the lady's chicer than chic, if her escort must wear a topper and each man's the man of the week, if she rides around in a brand new foreign car, the chances are the lady's a star. If the lady's brilliantly witty, if she makes the dialogue flash, if a lady's way with a ditty makes a ditty seem like a smash, if a song's add up to a fancy repertoire, the chances are the lady's a star.
Dance with me, I want my arms about you, the charm. She's a genuine,
positive,
totally marvelous, perfectly wonderful star.
I'm putting on my top hat, tying up my white tie, brushing up my tails. I'm doing up my shirt front, putting in the shirt studs, polishing my nails.
If the ball is party,
with tons of expensive caviar. If the lady's someone with the same credentials, someone with the same essentials, someone who is worshipped from afar. She's a genuine, positive, totally marvelous, perfectly wonderful star.
She's a genuine, positive,
totally, totally
marvelous,
perfectly
wonderful star.
She's a genuine, positive, totally marvelous lady.
Is that somebody's brown bedroll in the driveway with a rope around it?
Oh, it's Vicky's.
Oh, thank heaven. I thought I ran over a monk.
It must have fallen off the camper. Come on in and sit down, please. No, not there. That's for company.
By the way, I got a buddy coming over to rehearse with Kenny and me. Let me know when he gets here.
Oh, but who is it?
Bing Crosby.
Bing Crosby!
The one who went to Gonzaga University? The orange juice tycoon?
Yeah, and he's quite an inventor, too. He mixed that orange juice with vodka and milk of magnesia. Maybe you heard of it, the Phillips screwdriver.
Excuse me. I'm going to the house for a minute. I'll be right back.
Bye-bye. Just think, Bing Crosby. Now my Kenny can play for a real singer. Oh, a man whose trademark is ba-ba-ba-boo instead of a hiccup.
Well, I'll admit that Bing has a smooth voice. He gargles with saddle soap, you know.
Don't you stand up, Caruso. Bing Crosby is an inspiring Irish-American Catholic crooner. Who are you, huh?
A staggering Italian-Swiss colony baritone.
I just melt every time I hear Mr. Crosby sing that great song. Every time it rains, Kenny's from heaven.
That's pennies.
Not in my house.
I gotta go upstairs now.
You be nice to Kenny. Remember, if it wasn't for him, you'd still be making clam sauce for Franco-American.
Did that because they fired me as noodle bender. They caught me making obscene alphabet soup.
Well, what do you think of my old Gonzaga U sweater?
Well, it looks like you ate yourself out of college, huh?
I used to be much shorter in those days. Mrs. Lane, do you realize that I was the second Greek to be admitted to Gonzaga?
That's nice. Who was the first?
Bing Crosby.
Oh.
No, that's true. His real name was Crosmopolis.
Oh, come on.
I'm telling you, he changed his name to Crosby because they couldn't fit his Greek name on the record labels.
Well, then how did they do it in Greece?
They have very big records. I'm glad he's going to be here because as trustee of the Gonzaga Alumni Fund, I want to ask him for a small donation.
Now, Mr. Kapopoulos, please don't embarrass Mr. Crosby while he's a guest in my house. That must be him. Dean! Dean! He's here, Dean!
I'm here to see Kenny Lane.
How do you do?
Oh, say, incidentally, there's a brown bedroll out there in the driveway with a rope around it.
Yeah, it's my daughter's.
Oh, thank heavens. I thought I'd run over a hippie.
The monk joke was funnier.
Well, you got on first.
Hey, big thing.
How about the rehearsing?
Oh, no, first, I've got a big surprise for you. Look who is here.
Crosmopolis? Kapopoulos!
What's going on? What's he talking about?
I don't know, but don't get the Greeks angry. They'll cut off my supply of olives.
Wouldn't want that.
Don't you remember me? We were both varsity little lettermen. You in football, me in cheerleading. G-O-N-Z-A-G-A. G-O-N-Z-A-G-A. G-O-N-Z-A-G-A.
Good thing he didn't go to Kalamazoo.
Are you all right, Mr. Kapopoulos?
Hey, Big, if he's your best cheerleader, I'd hate to see the homecoming queen.
Oh, she would.
But as a fellow alumnus, I want you to make a small donation to build the Gazaga Bing Crosby Greek Memorial Outdoor Theater.
Well, I'd be glad to contribute a threepence. How much you want?
For you, very little. $7 million.
$7 million? I haven't been hit that hard by a Greek since Agnew hit me with his T-shirt.
Look, as one Greek to another, $5 million.
I want to tell you something. I think you got me confused with the real Gonzaga Gipper. That was Euripides Crosmopolis. I never got in a football game. 4 years of football, I only took one shower.
And even that was in the girls' locker room.
Well, you forget my minor was comparative anatomy.
Ben, you're not Greek?
Oh, Mr. Kapopoulos, you've made a no-assis of yourself.
How's it been going, baby? Listen, hey, now, don't you go away, because we got a lot more show right after the station break with my wonderful guest, Petula Clark, and Roy Rogers and Dale Evans, they'll be back, and my pal, Don Rickles, he's going to come on, and we're going to have such a fun time, you see? Once
wait
in a while,
a minute,
Don Rickles
wait
coming...
Wait a minute, hold it.
Hold
it. Hold it.
Hold what?
Hold it.
Hold what?
Yeah. What is this with my pal? The show is half over, and I haven't even been on yet. I mean, what...
You are my pal.
Good, good lines. You have a lot of good lines. I gotta tell you something, Dean.
Huh.
Really, from my heart. I'm not going anyplace with this show. You're supposed to have feelings for me. I've been watching the show, and so far, let me put it to you another way. It's a flaw. It's not making it.
But I'm saving you for the finish.
The finish? Huh, are you kidding? You know why the people are here? It's free. That's why. You people know it. It's a free show. This is the overflow from Let's Make a Deal. What do you think of that? I want you to. I want you to hit me. I'll press charges. What do you think of that? I want you to lay a hand on me, dummy. You'll have a lot of trouble on your hands.
Migraine, migraine.
Migraine, huh?
Migraine.
Find out
close.
What that means. Migraine. You're gonna be the head nurse. Now, I'll tell you something, Dean.
What?
You think people are crazy about you? They're not crazy about you. They think you're Tony Martin. That's why they're crazy about you.
Really?
You're going, good, good lines, really. Leave that out. Leave that out. Leave out all those things. Listen,
what?
The audience thought they were gonna win something. You gotta give these people something. You people came in, you wanna win something, right? You didn't come in. That's right. That's right, gang, there he is, Chiefy Dean. Doesn't go for $3. Why don't you give him a wallet with a Chester Morris picture in it, huh? I mean, folks, go home, watch television, watch Lyle Talbot on a travelogue tonight picking tulips. I mean this, you are a bad performer, Dean. Now, I'm a friend. I mean this from my heart.
She's gonna be next, Petula Clark.
Petula Clark?
I know, I'd back you up.
Touch me one more time and you go down. Why don't you do what you know best? Stagger around like a dummy for a half hour.
Oh, come on,
people.
Don't be so in exactly total strangers,
listen,
you know?
Come on.
Ah, there go my socks.
That's right. Stamp your feet, become a dummy. Now, I'll tell you something, Dean.
What?
I didn't have to be on this show.
Yes, you
no,
did.
That's the, no, I didn't. I had an offer for Ed Sullivan, but I turned it down because my bear died. What do you think of that? My bear died, and I didn't have to be on this show. I had a lot of offers, you know what I mean? Could have had farm reports, Captain Kangaroo, and I could have been on Whirly Birds. But I picked this show because I thought you were going to be kind to me. And I'm getting fed up with you, bro. What do you think of that?
But you've got a nice dressing room, a beautiful dressing room. Didn't I give you that, pal?
Dressing room? Dean, are you serious?
No, I'm Italian. Okay.
I didn't see the humor in that. And I'll tell you something, Dean. I happen to be sharing the dressing room with Trigger. What do you think of that? How would you like to go in the bathroom and see... I Did you ever look at your sink and see hay on top of it? This is a little embarrassing, Dean. I don't need this. I got a stall shower, and he thinks it's his stall. I'm getting fed up, Dean. I don't want to be on this anymore. I used makeup tonight. He ate it. Now, where am I going?
Hey, let's see.
As pure as the flowers in springtime, I work at the men's pants machine. My sweetheart goes by at another, while union love blossomed serene. One day I was sitting there sewing, not knowing that danger was near.
I feel beautiful, but you know, I got no luck. This morning, I took a walk on Sesame Street and got mugged by a kid. Everything happened to me this week. I was at a lunch the other day, and there was a sign in this restaurant that said, "Watch your hat and coat." While I was watching my hat and coat, somebody stole my pants. And will you hear this? Yesterday, I bought a television set. When I got home, it wasn't working. I called the store that sold it to me, and I told the guy, "I get sound, but there's no picture." He said, "Relax, I'll just charge you for a radio." Oh, you know, it's a small world, especially on your wedding night.
when you... It is, especially on your wedding night, when you run into a bellboy who turns out to be an old friend of your new wife.
We're going to have the finest wedding night any two people ever had.
Oh. Wait a minute, Harold. Why don't you go slip into something comfortable?
Good idea.
Oh, Harold. I'll go in and change.
Ben.
Hi, I'm the bellboy in this sketch.
You're out of luck. I'm the husband.
Now, either you're expecting company or you're wearing Tony Martin's pajamas.
Well, I see you put the champagne down. Here you are, and thank you very much.
Oh, hey, I noticed on the register you're from my hometown, Bayonne, New Jersey.
Well, actually, I'm from Secaucus, but my wife, Shirley, she's from Bayonne.
I once knew a girl from Bayonne named Shirley. Shirley Ponensky.
Shirley Ponensky? That's my wife.
You're kidding. You married Crazy Shirley?
Crazy Shirley?
Yeah, she always said she'd nail a rich man.
Now, just a minute here. Now, we must be talking about two different girls. Now, my wife's first name was Shirley Zelna Bernadette Frobisher Ponensky.
That's her. Back in Bayonne, she used to be a beauty queen. In 1968, the American Legion voted her Miss Wednesday Night Smoker.
Miss Wednesday Night Smoker? Hmm? You know, I always wondered where she went Wednesday night. Look, maybe it's not the same Shirley Zelda Bernadette Frobisher Ponensky.
Well, it gotta be. The other one left town 6 years ago. You're getting abroad with a lot of talent. She used to travel with the Les Brown's band.
She was a vocalist?
No. She used to travel with the band. Boy, that sure is a great broad. Where is she?
Well, she's inside, so slipping into something comfortable.
Yeah, I hope it's that red lacy thing.
You like that better than the blue.
Doesn't everybody? Hey, look at her. Does she still kiss with her eyes wide open?
Well, I wouldn't know. I always kiss with my eyes closed.
You kiss Crazy Shirley with your eyes closed? Watch your wallet.
Are you sure this is the same Shirley Zelda Bernadette Frobisher Ponensky?
Positive. I'll never forget her. She used to have the cutest way of saying no. Boy, I wish I were in your shoes.
I got a feeling you were. Dear, I've already tipped the bellboy. Dear. Well, if anybody wants me, I'll be standing right here.
Hey, I like that. Secondhand rose, secondhand rose. Her surgeon just gave her a secondhand nose. Open your mouth. You know, I've been a little dragged lately, but you just remember the famous words of the Pope, who once said to Michelangelo, "You can come down now, we've decided to wallpaper." I
Roger.
Hey, I'm sorry I'm late, Dean. I had to go to the doctor's.
That's all right. We've been doing anything wrong anyhow.
Yeah, I got a touch of gregarious reluctance. Did you ever have that?
No.
It's like a rapture, but it don't hurt, you know. I hate to go to doctors. I really do. They make me cuckoo. I really hate doctors. This doctor especially, he got an old nurse. You know, one of them old, real old, creepy old nurses. She's got wrinkled stockings. You know that kind? I was laughing at it until I realized she wasn't even wearing any. You know, she's got... Give me one of those, whom shall we notify in case of emergency? You know, the whom turns me off right away. So I said to her, wherefore do you have to know that? You know what I mean? I talk pretty good. She said, well, the doctor has to know who to call in case there's something wrong. I said, tell him to call a better doctor.
I always like to go to a lady doctor. It's nice to have a woman tell me to take my clothes off for a change, you know? Instead of the other way around.
Yeah, they give you all the good ones. You know? Then he come out, the doctor, and he says to me, gave me a thorough illumination, complete, you know? Then he says to me, well, you got low blood pressure, but I'm not worried about it. I said, marvelous. If you had low blood pressure, I won't worry about it. They're creeps anyway. I hate doctors. I mean that. I shouldn't say that out loud, but they're creeps. All of them. Physicians, surgeons, psychiatrists, deviated sectums, every one of them. They go to that medicinal school. They got to sign like a hypocrite oath, right? They graduate. You know about that? Yeah, that's a promise not to squeal. That's why they wear masks when they operate, the sturgeons.
Sturgeons?
In case something goes wrong, you say, who done it? The guy said, I don't know, I had a thing over here. You know who really does good, though? I gotta say, the research guys. They're the most best ones, the research guys, because they help people. I mean, really, if it wasn't for Fahrenheit, doctors wouldn't know how to took temperatures, right? And if it wasn't for, like, Pasteur, they wouldn't know how to kill germs. And before William Penn, they used to write the prescriptions with a pencil. Did you know that? They just opened up a laboratory. There was a doctor. What was his name? The Los Angeles Police Celebrity Medical Award this year was won by Dr. Melvin Whitebread. He invented brown shoes. And they gave it last year to Dr. Morton Viner. He invented Dr. Melvin Whitebread. You know what? I read this in the paper. I couldn't believe it. Uh-huh. They opened up a laboratory in Burning Blanket, Arizona. They took a flea. You believe this? In a big laboratory, and they're teaching the flea to fly. A laboratory optician took a little teeny flea, and he strapped him to a surgical table. And he inserted a water jamputer into the flea's digital cavity. Serious now, sit still. They could push a button, this laboratory optician, and increase the flow of the wattage through the amperes, and they could tell the flea what to do, and he would did it. Oh yeah, they call him fly flea, and the flea flew. They told him, don't flee no more, and he didn't flip. Do you believe that? Then they did what they call an advanced research. See, they got some money from the Edsel Foundation. And they removed the wings from the flea. And the doctor said, fly, flea, and the flea just stood there. He said, fly, flea, the flea didn't even move. Then he grabbed his notebook, he wrote a brilliant observation. He wrote, when you remove wings from fleas, they become deaf.
When my baby smiles at me, my heart goes rolling. I said, roll, you're such a paradise. Why, you know, I sigh, I cry. Now it's just a bit of heaven. When my baby smiles, is everybody happy?
time. Your time.
I got rhythm, I got music, I got mime, and who could ask for anything more?
Your time is up.
Oh.
When my daddy left home, he run and hid. But the meanest thing he ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue.
Good night, Bill Walker!
A-dink-a-doo, a-dink-a-dee, a-dink-a-doo simply means ink. A-dink-a-dee, a-dink-a-doo. Everybody wants to get into the act.
Everybody's got a little song. Some favorite thing that they can sing along. Even though it's not a symphony or sonata, everybody's got a song.
The first time I met Dean, I was hired to direct a special. Maybe 3 years before the variety show went on the air. I'd never met him. And I went up to Las Vegas to see him perform. Now, keep in mind, this is after he left Jerry and he was working at the Sands Hotel. And I sat down with a writer that I came up there with, and we watched Dean perform. And he came out, and the announcer said, "Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, direct from the bar, Dean Martin." And Dean walked out on stage with a glass in his hand. And he stood in front of the microphone like this with his glass in his hand for 10 seconds. He didn't say anything. Then 15 seconds. And he still didn't say anything. And he took a sip. And now almost 30 seconds have gone by. Now 30 seconds is an eternity. And the audience is starting to giggle. And now they're starting to laugh because he's acting like he's half bombed. And he finally turns to the audience and he goes, "Hey, how long I've been on?" And it gets a big laugh. And then he goes ahead and he does his act. And halfway through his act, you think he's really loaded. And now I go backstage to meet him for the first time. And I walk in and I go, "Hey, Dean, I'm Greg Garrison." And he went, "Hey, pal, how are you?" And he's cold, dead sober. And I looked at him and he went, "Fooled you, didn't I?" And I went, "Oh, my goodness. It's the greatest drunk act I've ever seen."
You got two red eyes already.
You're gonna have one, too.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
Why? Why? I'm all tuckered out. Think I'll sit down and rest my tucker.
You will.
You give me a drink, will you?
No, listen, you should be ashamed of yourself. A man of medicine, you should set an example. Do you realize that you have not been in an operating room in 10 years?
Why should I? I haven't been sick.
How can you call yourself a doctor boozed up all the time? You want to put a stop to that.
I'll drink to that.
Whoa!
Doc. What? You gotta help me. I've lost a lot of blood.
No, you haven't. It's right there on the floor.
Please, Doc, take me to the office.
You're in it.
Doctor, here's your big chance. To help this man, go find him another doctor.
There, where? Fill this prescription. Okay.
What?
Here's the prescription. Fill it. You know something? You look better already. I ought to warn you, I haven't practice in 20 years.
That's all right, Doc. I ain't been hit by an error in 30 years. Come on, do something, Doc.
All right, I'll try. I'll try to do something. Wee! How did it happen?
Oh, not now, Doc. That's a long story.
Oh, well, don't you worry. I got time. Here, bring us a couple of drinks for me and my friends.
Oh, Doc, what about the arrow?
Bring the arrow a drink, too.
You gotta help me, Doc. I'm dying.
Well, the first thing you gotta do is quit smoking.
Doc, don't you understand? I don't want to die. I want to live so I can have my own ranch, ride my mare off into the sunset, might even meet the girl of my dreams, have some babies.
Who's going to marry you with an arrow in your chest?
Don't just stand there looking at this poor fella die. Don't do that. Don't just stand there looking at this poor fella die. Don't you understand that it's mean of you to just look at him die? Why don't you do that? Why?
I'll just cover my eye. Then I won't have to look at him anymore.
I'm ashamed of you. I remember.
You better remember, because it's going to be your last show.
You remember what? I remember when you were the top doctor in the West, and you pulled 12 arrows. You know what I mean, those things, them, 12 of those, out of Billy the Kid, and he didn't even scream.
How could he? He was dead for 3 days.
Look, I can't stand it anymore. If you can't help me, I'm gonna get out of here. Gotta be a doctor somewhere.
Well, the nearest one is in Arizona.
By the time I get to Phoenix, I'll be dying.
Any other songs you want to plug before you go?
Well, this arrow ain't gentle on my heart.
Listen to me. You are not getting another drink until you help this man. Do you understand that?
All right, I'll do it. First, I got to make sure I'm sterile. Pour some alcohol there on it. Hand there.
Joe, hurry up, this hurts.
That stuff is finger looking good. Come in, folks. Don't send them to Andy. Send them to me. And this week, I especially want to thank the little old lady who sent me that pair of monogram socks. I like to have socks with my initials on them, because when I look under the table, I can tell which feet are mine.